This video is for contributors of ELTGlobalVillage.com membership website for how to post content yourself rather than just dragging the files to the big green box. If you want to actually have more control and post whenever you want and instantly see the results, because if you post yourself, then you're going to have that content immediately accessible on the website. So once you log in, again, by default, you're going to go to the big green box page. And from there, you don't have to worry about the big green box. You can bypass that by just going to New Post. Click on New Post. And by the way, if you haven't read the Quick Start Guide, you might want to think about doing that. New Post. I'm going to click on that. And I will be able to create, just like if you're familiar with WordPress at all. If you have your own blog site, you're probably already familiar with this. Maybe not. Maybe you have a VA that does it for you. But you can post any content here you want. Here's the title. My cool title. You know, whatever it is. And down here is where you put your content. Okay? And you have a lot of similar options like you do in Microsoft Word. Bold, italic, underline. If you want a bulleted list, etc., justifying left, right, links, etc. You can even put tables in there, but I wouldn't recommend that unless you kind of know what you're doing. So here I am, and I can just start typing, here's my awesome content, blah, blah, blah. And I can just keep typing on here. And if I select something, double-click on a word or click and drag to select multiple words and click bold, you know, you have that option. Okay, you can format. But what I like to do, and a lot of people like to do, is write in Microsoft Word, format in Microsoft Word, and then copy that and paste it in here. So I'm going to restore down or resize this window so I can see my content over here on the desktop. And if you don't see your content, then you can just find it and resize the window, or just minimize, like I just did. I minimized the browser. So if you minimize the browser and everything else, you'll see your desktop. And then you can just navigate to your files and open something up. Like here's something I wrote, Jim Carrey, his words of wisdom from a speech that he had. And I'm just going to select all because I've already formatted it. There's a bullet list here. There's bolding, there's italic, etc. It's all formatted. So I'm just going to select all. Control A is the shortcut to select all. And then copy. Control C, or you can click the button over here. Control C. That copies it. I'm in Word. I edited it all in Word, Microsoft Word. I'm going to minimize this. Go back to the browser window where I was editing my post. And all I have to do is paste inside of the edit box here. Control V is the shortcut for pasting. Control V, and did it work? Do I have, let me maximize here, make it easier to see everything. Yeah, look at that. We retained all the formatting. And here is the title. So I'm going to just copy that. And I can put the whole thing up there if I wanted to. Copy. And I'm going to scroll up a little bit, and I'm going to change that title to Jim Carrey's Wow Words of Wisdom. I'm going to delete this content at the top here. Click and drag to select something. Backspace to delete it. I need to move this up one line, so I put my cursor to the left of that text. Backspace. Wonderful. Now I can either publish right now, and it'll be live on the site, or save draft, and then publish it later. But before you do either one of those, what I want you to do, you know, make your edits in here. I'm going to get rid of that because that doesn't need to be there because I've got the title up here. Backspace. Okay. Two things you must do is select the category because that's how it shows up on your village. Okay. So you have to do this. Me, I'm Happy Valley. So I'm going to click on the Happy Valley box. Only that one. For you, whatever your villages in the category section, you're going to click that box, okay? And you're going to scroll to the very bottom of the page, very bottom, and you're going to see the section called Wishlist Member. It might be minimized first time you use it. So if it's minimized, you click the little down arrow right here, Wishlist Member, down arrow, click, and bada bing, it opens it up. And you want to make sure it says, yes, protect this content, members only. And click the first checkbox, which will select all the checkboxes, because you want everybody to have access to this content. Okay, so those things are absolutely necessary for every post you make on this website. Click your category. Just one box should be selected here, your village category. Yes, protect this content, and make sure all these boxes are selected, and that's it. Just leave everything else alone, and either publish or save draft. I'm going to go ahead and publish this, and let's see what happens once it saves it. I want to make sure the name shows up like I want it to up here. Yep. So here's the URL, eltglobalvillage.com/happyvalley. That's my category or my village, and then the name of the actual post there. It goes down to Jim Carrey's words. Wow, words of wisdom. Perfect. So that's the URL. And if I want to view this, view post, I'm going to right click and open it up in a new tab. I like to do that so I can keep this open and just flip back and forth. See, I've got multiple tabs now. And there it is. There's my post that I just posted myself. And people can leave comments underneath here. Beautiful. Okay, so that's how easy it is to post text, like an article. If you wrote something, you want to copy and paste it into here. And that's pretty much it. If you want to log out from here, you can do it here on the top right. You hover over your name and it'll pop down to, you'll see log out as an option. Okay. If you're on the normal page and you can't figure out how to get back to here, because this is kind of the back end of WordPress, here's how you do it. If you're over here, because WordPress 4.0 or later, they got rid of the black bar at the top. You can't access this anymore. You used to be able to. Since that's gone, the way you get back to this section where you can actually do some things, like add a new post, right? New post is, here's how you get back. If you scroll down, you go, Dave, I can't get back, man. All you have to do is not log out, membership details. Click on membership details, and what's going to happen is you're going to have the ability to change your membership details, your profile stuff, if you want. If you want to change your password, you can do that on this page, new password, repeat password, but we don't want to go here for that reason. The only reason we clicked on that is so that I can create a new post if I want to keep posting, okay? Or I can go to posts, new post. And if I wanted to see all my posts so far that I posted, I click all posts, and that is going to show them in a list. I don't know how many I have here. I've got, okay, three that this user, this is like a bogus user I created, Davidude Humananda. That's not my normal, you know, posting thing, but for the sake of this video, that's how many I have. So, you know, yours are going to show up in this list here. You can edit them, you can trash them, you can preview them. Quick edit or edit is a super edit that allows you to go back to the original edit page. Quick edit is just a quick way to change the name of it. If you made a mistake on the categories, you can fix that here. Or if you have, doesn't look like it's going to give me an option of changing the author. I can do that as an admin. If you accidentally, you know, post it under a wrong or a different author and you want it to be you, or your admin did it, your VA did it, and you want it under your name, let me know and I can change that for you. So update or cancel. And if I want to view this page again, any one of these, I can go to preview, or because that's a draft, that's not posted yet. View. And then if I want to log out, I have the log out over here. If I want to get back into create new posts, then I can go back to membership details and click new post. Now, here's a little cool tip for you. Instead of having to do that even, you can, here's the new post, right? New button up here, new post. If I drag that up into the bookmarks bar here, it'll create a shortcut. Boom, bada bing. And I already have one up there, so I don't really need two. So I'm gonna just go ahead and delete it. Right click on it to delete it and select delete. But it's right here. So, you know, if I'm viewing a particular page, you know, a post that I made, and I want to create a new post, if I'm viewing this, all I have to do, instead of having to go through this button and then click new post, is I've got a bookmark right here. So I just click that and boom, I'm creating a new post. And I can just keep creating new posts, you know, once a week or at least once a month. If you can commit to that, that would be awesome, because the more content we have, the better for everyone, the better for the membership members, and the better the site is, more attractive and long-term successful. Everybody makes more money. It's a win-win. So let me go back to, if I go to visit the site, it's another thing I wanted to show you. You might go there and go, oh no, there's no buttons. How do I get out of here? Well, at the very bottom of that page, this is the home page, is your login, or if you're logged in, it'll say log out, or membership details, and that'll get you back also to the area where you can continue to make new posts if you haven't already made a shortcut up here, you know, or bookmarked it some other way. So it's not that complicated. Again, if you're familiar with WordPress, this is going to be no problem for you. But if you're kind of new to WordPress, add new post, add new post. Three different ways to create a new post once you're in this section. Okay, but if you're visiting a page, then again, all you have to do is click the membership details to get into the back end, or if you make a bookmark, new post. Here's the big green box. If you want to upload a file that way, click on the, well, you got to create that bookmark. I did that already. So the very first time, as soon as you log in, you might want to turn this page into a bookmark. How do you do that? In all those browsers, Firefox, Chrome, Internet Explorer, up at the URL field here, okay, that little icon, drag to taskbar to pin site. Basically, that turns it into a bookmark on the bookmarks bar, provided this is showing. So I just click this, hold it down, and drag to here, and that's going to turn that into a bookmark. Now, I already have one here, so I'm going to right-click and delete it. So now I can always go to big green box, no matter where I am in the website. And I have a bookmark here also as login. So the first time you log in, before you click log in, turn it into a bookmark. So the three I'd recommend for sure is log in, big green box, that's the page you're going to go to as soon as you log in, and then new post. And all I have to do is drag new post, left side of your mouse, drag it up here, and then that turns it into a, I'm going to cancel that because I already have one up there, a new post shortcut, okay? Of course, it's always on this page. So either way, to log out on this page, just log out on the bottom. The other pages, when you're in the back end, if I was on the new post, the way you could log out from here is hovering over your name and then go to log out. Either one of those will work to log out.